Yep, yep. And we want to welcome you to a very special day here on the campus of NJIT to a terrific athletic department celebrating a terrific moment which took place 10 months ago to the date when the NJIT men's soccer team wound up beating Florida Gulf Coast here on their home field here at Lubetkin Field at Mal Simon Stadium, as a result becoming ASUN tournament champions and punching a ticket to the NCAA Division I soccer tournament. And just a special moment and a first here for NJIT in any sport to make it to the Division I NCAA tournament. With all of that, we want to welcome you here to the pitch at the campus of NJIT. I'm Matt Provins, and we thank you for taking time out to watch this special edition of the Highlanders Sports Network. And boy, I tell you, this was a well-earned moment, really, for these soccer players and for this athletic department. But it all started before the season, when the head coach of this program, going into his fourth year, Fernando Barbodo, said, "Believe in greatness. Believe in greatness." And what this team was able to accomplish really mirrored what the whole goal for the season was. This was a team that started 2-3-3 after the first 8 matches. This was a team that had finished last in the ASUN the year before, but they kept on pushing and they kept on fighting, wound up winning 8 of their last 10 matches, including 5 in a row, that 5th being for that ASUN tournament championship. And they would wind up making their way again to a date with Providence in the NCAA tournament. But such a special moment. First time in 42 years any program at this school was able to make it to an NCAA tournament. The last time, 1977, when the men's soccer team was able to do so as a Division III under the tutelage of Mal Simon himself, a guy that coached here from 1955 all the way to 1983, and several accolades, including 3 trips into tournaments. And we'll talk more about the history of this program as we move along. But today is the day of celebrating the 2019 edition of men's soccer here at NJIT, one that culminated, of course, in not only a regular season championship, but of course, as I've mentioned a couple of times, a conference championship tournament time in the ASUN. And there's a lot to do today, a lot to unravel and unpackage, but the key and the highlight being the rings here for this ring ceremony that these players will receive for their efforts, marvelous efforts as it was. And by the way, they were able to do so here right on their home field as they clinched that number 1 seed and, of course, home field advantage throughout the course of the ASUN tournament. So again, so much to do here today, and we want to thank you for tuning in. We're going to hear from many people, including the president of the university, Joel Bloom. We're going to hear from, of course, the head of the athletic department, and of course, an associate vice president here in Lenny Kaplan, who's been here since 2000. Guys who have really put a lot of blood and sweat and tears into making this athletic department what it is today. And another thing we'll talk about, too, is the fact that this team is now going to join the America East Conference. So the evolution and the success on the field for this program and the athletic department continues at NJIT, and today again is a hallmark of the accomplishments that we have seen throughout the years. So we're going to start by having the players come out here momentarily, but as we wait for that moment, it is important to note that in the first year of the American East, this team will return for a chance to defend a championship, this time as America, a member of the American East, now in the spring. More about that, of course, later on. But right now, we do have the public address announcement here, bringing our players out here and welcoming everybody to what has turned out to be a terrific afternoon here in Newark to celebrate a 2019 ASUN Men's Soccer Championship.
Today on the Lubetkin Field at Mal Simon Stadium, we honor the 2019 NJIT Men's Soccer Team for winning the 2019 ASUN Championship and advancing to the NCAA Division I Men's Soccer Tournament. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the field the NJIT men's soccer coaching staff and administration. Director of Men's Soccer Operations, Evan Marks. Assistant coach, Augie Freitas. Assistant coach, Matthew Urey. the 2019 ASUN Head Coach of the Year, Fernando Barbodo. Strength and Conditioning Coach, Bobby Fisk. NJIT Associate Vice President and Director of Athletics, Lenny Kaplan. And NJIT President, Dr. Joel Bloom. Ladies and gentlemen, now please welcome to the field the 2019 ASUN Men's Soccer Tournament and Regular Season Champions, your Highlanders of NJIT.
So you see the soccer team coming in here and taking their seats on the pitch in anticipation of receiving the rings and hearing a little bit more. But, you know, you talk about that belief in greatness, and you look about not only a team accolade and the ability to get to the NCAA tournament and tie a school record for wins at 10, but you look at the individuals, and how about a major sweep of all the big awards at the ASUN Conference Men's Soccer offers?
At this time, the Coach of the Year, Fernando Barbodo,
Player of the Year in Rennie White, your Goalkeeper of the Year in Samuel Rizgus, and, of course, the Rookie of the Year in Alejandro Rebel. I mean, it was really an amazing accomplishment to not only put up those wins, but to have so many high-quality performers who were able to receive all these awards. I mean, really, a sweep is something you don't often see, and the fact that NJIT was represented in every major category was just another sign of how well this team was built and put together. And you felt great for Fernando Barbodo. I mean, here's a guy that had 13 seasons as a head coach in Iona, a guy that was in his fourth year at NJIT, had never been to the NCAA tournament as a head coach. That obviously would come to an end this season. And so you're really happy for a guy that you have seen provide results to this program. 4 years now, and in three of those, eight or more wins, including, of course, the record-tying 10 that he had this past season. So it goes to show you what he has been able to accomplish in a very short amount of time here at NJIT. And, of course, he always points out how effective his assistant coaching staff is to always making sure that they get their proper accolades. They were honored as they came out to the field as well, starting with the operations director and Evan Marquez, Augie Freitas, who's an assistant coach, and Matt Yuley, another assistant coach. Collectively, that group also was able to receive some accolade as the whole staff was part of the Atlantic Region Staff of the Year. So as all the accolades would go, the group of coaches also honored this season as well, following what was a magical season here for the NJIT men's soccer program. So right now they're going through some of the resume and explaining to the audience that has come here to take in the event some of the things that were accomplished by this team. And it's great because I look up and I see so many of their brethren, the women's volleyball team, the women's basketball team, the men's basketball team, collection of students, other athletes from the other organizations, other teams and programs here taking in this moment, hoping too that they'll have a chance to have this. As I mentioned earlier, hadn't had something like this since 2013 when the women's basketball program was the Great West Conference champions. That took place in Chicago, and that was the last Great West Conference tournament that they would ever have. And that's kind of ironic too, in the sense that the women's basketball program under Steve Lamphier at that point remaining the reigning champions of the Great West Conference, as that conference soon was, again, went defunct. So back here, and we are going to have more from what's taking place here at Lubetkin Field at Mal Simon Stadium, going through some of the accolades for these players here, showing some video to those in attendance. And it's great because we were here for that event, a cold night in November. This is a team that fell behind a high-powered Florida Gulf Coast team. In fact, trailing 1-0 on a goal that was scored with 12 seconds to go in the first half, putting the Eagles up. NJIT had to come from behind and did so, of course, with a goal in the 70th minute and eventually a game winner by Watkins in the 86th minute, becoming the game winner and eventually the tournament conference champion clincher. He, of course...
our players' family members that were able to make it here today, as well as our other student athletes and staff, as none of this is possible without everybody's support. I'd also like to recognize and thank NJIT's President Joel Bloom for his ongoing support and dedication to not only the athletic department, but especially to our student athletes. As many of you know, we were hoping to celebrate this accomplishment in a more traditional way, in front of the student body, our many alumni, be it before a regular season game or at homecoming. Unfortunately, the pandemic got in the way, but in lieu of those events, I cannot think of any better way than to celebrate with families, our student athletes, our department staff, as it was our first championship to get us into the NCAA tournament. It was a very special moment that has been shared by all, and as we say, one school, one team. At NJIT, as mentioned, we've had a great history in men's soccer. We've had Olympians. We've had 19 All-Americans. We had a 1960 NIA National Championship and 61 runner-up. And because of this history, in 2005, NJIT men's soccer was our first sport to be elevated to the Division I level, and it's only so fitting it's our first one in the NCAA Division I tournament. This season added to that great history, and it was special in so many ways, with the opening and rededication of the Lubetkin Field to Mal Simon Stadium. And for our seniors playing on this field, represented their first ever on-campus home game. We won our first, and coincidentally our last, ASUN regular season and tournament championship, and earned our first ever NCAA Division I postseason tournament bid. Congrats to all. I cannot say enough about this team, its great coaching staff led by Fernando Barboto, and a bunch of tremendous student athletes. And they are just that, student athletes. I want to thank Coach Barboto and the team for all these special memories. You've most definitely earned this special day and a special place in the history of NJIT athletics. I'm looking forward to making new memories, like winning our first America East Championship this spring, and that would be a great place to start. I want to thank everyone again for being here to help celebrate this tremendous accomplishment, and Roll Tech.
Thank you, Lenny Kaplan. Now please welcome NJIT President Dr. Joel Bloom to the podium.
Thank you. So this is one of the few events so far that we've convened other than classes on campus. And it should be. It was a memorable season. Outstanding performances by many, starting with our student athletes and our coaching staff. But I also want to acknowledge really where it all began, and that's that group of folks sitting over there. We thank you for your sons here on this field. We thank you for sending them to this outstanding institution, and we saw them perform outstandingly during this past year's season. This is very important for this university. To have student athletes, you probably know, I've recited this and our AD has recited this for years now, but we're up to 20, how many seasons of 3.0? 23 seasons of 3.0. I won't ask how many of you have taken calculus and passed it with A's and B's, but I know some of you have, or some of you in the stands. And by the way, those of you in the stands today, we thank you for turning out. We thank you for social distancing on campus. Please keep your masks on. We have an amazing record. I almost don't want to recite it out of fear that it could change quickly. But we've all had since March only 9 cases of the COVID-19 on this campus. The past 2 weeks, we've had 0. So that's because of the students, the work that the staff have done here in making sure, and all of the students who are here making sure that we are safe. We know we're smart, but we also have to be safe. And although it's a great inconvenience putting up with this deadly virus, it is worth the inconvenience. So we had this outstanding record, 5-1, if I remember correctly. I wasn't here for the last game. I was with some alumni in Florida. We knew the game was going to occur, but one of the things I have to do, and maybe I'll come and circulate a little while and ask you all for money, but that's what I was doing in Florida. And we watched the game with our chair of our board of trustees, other trustees down there, and it was just an amazing win. And they went on to have an amazing season. They couldn't have done it without our coaching staff, our strength and conditioning staff as well, and all of you who are here today. So congratulations. We probably won't see, maybe we'll see a spring repeat. What do you think, Lenny? And I can't sit down without telling you how important Lenny Kaplan is, not only to this program, the field we're standing on, the building that's I'm looking at is behind many of you. Lenny has done and continues to do an outstanding job along with his staff in this very, very important function here at NJIT, our athletics, our athletic teams, and how well they all do perform and how hard they work as students and as athletes. So have a great day. Please stay well. Please, students, stay smart. And I look forward to seeing you again. Take care.
Thank you, President Bloom. At this time, we would like to relive the great moments from the 2019 championship season. Please direct your attention to the video board for this special presentation.
The level expectation is high. We finally have our field, our stadium, which is beautiful. That is a big component in building the culture that I'm trying to set.
Most of us are hoping to win the ASUN Championship this year. That's sort of the goal for the team.
NJIT wins it back. A through ball towards Watkins and Regsan. Watkins with his first goal at the Division I level.
He's going to send it in with the left foot and a diving stop, a deflection by Riges. They keep it in play, however.
And a pass ahead and a goal here at the 9:01 mark, the second of the match by White.
Trying to get some space, Radon takes it and scores. With the strong right foot into the upper 90. Scamaro looking to get that right foot shot off, and he blasts one, scores! Chance Watkins with his left foot to Radon, and he puts it in the empty net.
We've had some tough opponents here at home, and it was great to get our first conference win at home and get a shutout and score 3 goals.
That's initial shots deflected, but here comes Radon. Plays it through to Rebel, who scores. The left wing, Rebel advancing against Lawrence. Left foot cross off toward White, and he tips it in. Finds some space, crosses to White. White with a right foot shot, he scores again. Dances, gives it to Cubero again with the right foot blast, and he scores. He's able to touch it down to Rebel. Rebel with some space, he shoots and scores. counter. It's Rennie White. Blasts one from long range, and he scores again! The defense on the left wing into the box, around the goalkeeper. He scores again.
Says the ASUN regular season champions are the NJIT Highlanders. A 5-0 dominating win over the Jacksonville Dolphins to clinch the ASUN regular season title. The first Division I conference championship for NJIT in program history.
On the feet in the box. Rebell with the shot blasted home. And NJIT going up 1-0 thanks to the Puerto Rican freshman Alejandro Rebell.
Off target by White, but a through ball here. White with a chance to make it 2-0, and he will.
Flag is staying down, and it's 2-0 Highlanders. Into the 18, the feet to Watkins for the finish, and gets it through. Off the hand of the defender, Leo Portero in goal, and Regsan Watkins right on cue, off a turnover, a finish to put NJIT ahead 3-1 with under 10 left to go. Today, NJIT has the higher ground. The Highlanders take down the Stetson Hatters 3-2, and the number one seed this year set to host the ASUN Championship game Saturday against Florida Gulf Coast University.
Takes these. He does with the right foot. A diving save. Gavigan, the rebound. They score. It's Rebell, the ASUN freshman of the year, ties it at one.
Near side against Clements. Left foot pass into the box. Punched away by Gavigan. Following up Watkins, and he scores. None bigger than just now. The Highlanders have the lead. NJIT Highlanders from worst to first. Their first conference title in the Division I era in the ASUN. And their first berth in the NCAA tournament in 42 years. The fans rush the field in Newark. What a comeback for NJIT.
Taking on Penn State will be the winners of the first round match with Providence and New Jersey Institute.
What a memorable season for the Highlanders. Before we present the rings, let's first recognize the student athletes who could not be in attendance today. Midfielder from Seoul, South Korea, number 23, Hyun Sung Hong.
Obviously, they still want to make sure they are announced here. So that list includes a midfielder from Seoul, South Korea, Hyung Sung Hong, a forward from El Paso, Texas, and Bardo Lerma, a defenseman from Elche, Spain, Javier Anton, midfielder from Miami, Florida, Andy Alvarez, midfielder from Cincinnati, Ohio, Ryan Melnick, who, by the way, played very well in the ASUN Tournament, a tough midfielder, a guy that transferred here from Cincinnati, and then a goalkeeper from Castellon, Spain, and Victor Pohatis, who's been a big part of this program. And we've mentioned Regsan Watkins a bunch of times. He is not able to be here today, but of course, he is here on video and in spirit as he was the tournament MVP. We miss him and can't wait to see his excitement in this upcoming season. Meanwhile, they are starting with the rings, and it starts with a forward sophomore from Carlstadt, New Jersey, a St. Peter's Prep product. That's a forward, Paul Konjewicz, who is the first up to get that ring. So if you're Paul Konjewicz, you're kind of excited, right? I mean, you're the first guy to get the hardware and to take in what was a beautifully designed ring by Joe Vakin, the business management department. He was able to help spearhead that program with the others in the athletic department for a great-looking ring that we're going to learn about a little bit later on. Jason Ricca, a guy from Bloomfield, New Jersey, a sophomore midfield, very quick, agile player, gets his ring next. And he's a guy they're excited about, really adds some depth to the attack, and as a young player, hopes to see a lot more time in the upcoming season after appearing in three matches in this 2019 championship season. Next up from North Arlington, New Jersey, a defenseman, Michael Gomez. And Gomez, another sophomore, he's a Paramus Catholic product and a business management major here at NJIT. Another good young player that you feel so excited about here for Fernando Barbota, who still has very deep coffers after winning a conference championship a year ago. Our fourth ring, as we stay in the back, goes to another defenseman from Cliffside Park, New Jersey. It's Gabriel Souza. Souza, a year ago, appeared in a couple of matches, came here to NJIT from Bergen County Technical, and as I mentioned, had a little bit of experience his first year, but was just a freshman a year ago, so still an exciting young player with a career ahead of him here at NJIT. And that's what's nice. Again, you hear a lot of youngsters, a lot of freshmen, a lot of sophomores from last year's team returning. All right, let's keep it in the back and go to Nicosia Cyprus, and Andreas Nicolau is the next to get a ring here. So Nicolau out there getting a handshake from the very tall Highlander. By the way, that Highlander, he is quite a rebounder, too, on the basketball court. Meanwhile, Nicolau gets his ring from all the way from Cyprus. Another defenseman here in this program. Go back to the midfield, and a product of Biloxi, Mississippi, and Fabrizio Doria is the next up to get his ring. And, you know, if you are one of these underclassmen here for this NJIT men's soccer program, I mean, it's one thing you have to understand. I mean, you're talking a dearth of rings for most programs. It is not easy to win a ring. And the ring that was designed for this program, for this team, was spectacular. A lot of things to remember the great season by. So very fortunate to be part of your youngster to join in at such a good time under the tutelage of Fernando Barbota. Here's another New Jersey native from Hackensack. It's Santiago Martinez. He was a freshman, appeared in five matches this past season, getting his ring. And he'll be followed by another Jersey native. This is from Jersey City, a forward, Luke Smith, next up to get his ring. Smith, a St. Peter's Prep product. He was a sophomore that appeared a whole lot of playing time, appearing in 13 matches this season, wound up with 3 points, including a goal and an assist. And now a ring. Next up, Sabania, Costa Rica, a defenseman, number two, Roberto Adamson Hernandez. He was a junior a year ago, a defender going into his senior season, appeared in three matches for Barbota. And next up, goalkeeper, Anthony Caruso. Caruso, a junior a year ago, now into his senior year. Product of Wrightstown, Pennsylvania, and Council Rock North. He got action in a couple of games this season and was able to record a few saves and be part of a couple of combined clean sheets. Didn't have a whole lot of time to play behind a senior leader, Victor Pujadas, and both of those two playing second fiddle to the ASUN goalkeeper of the year, a freshman last year, in Samuel Reisgis. But certainly the three of those guys providing terrific leadership between the pipes. All right, next up, we go to a defenseman from Wallington, New Jersey. This is Nicholas Kozdrin. And Kozdrin wears that number 24 on his jersey. He's a Wallington, New Jersey native. 9 games, 3 starts a year ago. So a big part of the back end here for the defensive unit of Fernando Barbota. Our next string is going to go to a midfielder from Scotch Plains, New Jersey. This is Zach Halma. Halma, 13 games, 8 starts a year ago for the Scotch Plains Fanwood product. He'll have a redshirt senior year coming up this season. Very excited about that. And he'll be back as well. Now a midfielder from Union, New Jersey. This is Diogo Ferreira. And Diogo last year appeared in all 19 matches, had 17 starts, 4 points for the redshirt junior product of the Wardlow Hartridge High School, I beg your pardon. But he'll be back for another year as well. All right, next up, ASUN all-freshman team player, a defenseman from Maui, from Hawaii. It's Ariel Rusnak. And Rusnak, what a great freshman season. All freshman, as mentioned a moment ago, appeared in 19 games, 18 starts as a freshman. Good technique, really fits the style here for Fernando Barbota. He's followed by another defenseman from Bilbao, Spain. It's Jose Adames. And Adames had 14 games and 4 starts, had an assist last year. Again, another young player in this program, back for a sophomore year. All right, another guy who collected hardware at the end of the season, an ASUN second-team all-conference player, a defenseman from Lisbon, Portugal. This is Joao Costa. And Joao, second-team performer, had 18 games, 17 starts, did score a goal in his first year, and he'll be back as a junior this year. All right, another Jersey product. We had gone away from the Garden State for a few players, but here's another ASUN second-team all-conference performer, a forward. This is Gerald Cabrero. Cabrero's family is here in attendance as well. And what a great season, highlighted by his ASUN Player of the Week back towards the end of October. And remember, he scored both the goals in that first win. That was the one at Florida Gulf Coast against the team they would eventually play for the championship. And 5 goals in all in his 19 starts. Great year for Cabrero, a junior. All right, we move along. And here's another all-ASUN second-team performer. This is a midfielder from Sparta, New Jersey, Thomas Radon. Radon was also a member of the all-tournament team and assisted the game-tying goal in the final, scored by this guy, Alejandro Rebel. So his assist to Rebel set up the championship. Radon, by the way, a Jersey kid coming off a great season. With 18 games, all starts. And that'll segue to Rebel. Rebel is a freshman, was a freshman of the year, a member of the all-tournament team, had that game-tying kick in the finals, as I talked about, scoring the goal in the 70th minute. Always seemed to have really big goals, including assisting the first goal at Florida Gulf Coast to Cabrero, and then scoring the first goal in the semifinals against Stetson here on this pitch. So a great first year for Rebel. All right, how about this player? This is the ring is not going to get by him because he's the ASUN goalkeeper of the year, the ASUN first team performer, and the ASUN all-freshman player of the year. And that was Samuel Reisges, a Germany product. You know, Germany produces so many good goalkeepers. We saw one. He led the ASUN in saves and in save percentage and was third in goals against average. All right, moving along, a midfielder from Union City, a first-team all-conference player. This is Andrew Nino, who, by the way, is the all-time Division I career assist leader program here at NJIT with 17 of them, 8 coming this past year. A terrific player, first-team performer from Union City, New Jersey, and Andrew Nino. Next up is another second-team performer. This is a midfielder from Kearney, New Jersey. This is Juan Zapata. Second team performer, but a guy that Fernando Barbota calls our steal. He was a captain and wore that C with a lot of pride. A 4-year player, 67 matches, which is in the top 10 in the Division I era. So certainly it was great to see him be rewarded for his career here at NJIT with a ring. And then really don't need to introduce this guy, unanimous ASUN Player of the Year, ASUN First Team Player, of course, an all-tournament team selection, a forward from Bloomfield, New Jersey, a guy that was tied for the nation's lead in goals, 17 of them this past year. He was in his redshirt junior year. It is Rennie White, who led the ASUN in goals, points, and shots, and is the all-time career leader in points. points and goals scored. And as Fernando Barboto says about Rennie White, the best finisher I have ever had. And so White posing for a photo opportunity with Dr. Joel Bloom, the president, and the athletic director and associate vice president, Lenny Kaplan, both of whom you heard from earlier at the podium. Three very impressive people and personalities here at NJIT. Rennie White, really a great representative of that men's soccer program. And now here comes the Highlander, who's going to make his way to the podium. And this is when the men who have done such a great job in building this program, allowing this facility to get up, the funding for it, all the work and making sure it was exactly what NJIT needed for its size to recruit students and provide the best possible facilities for student athletes. These two guys worked so hard over their 10 years, 30 years for Dr. Joel Bloom, 20 years for Lenny Kaplan, and their rings awarded to them. Of course, Rennie White, you just saw a moment ago, get his ring. So he's out there presenting one. Special moment, I'm sure, for him, as well as a representative of the program. And we're going to get the coaching staff rings as well. Juan Zapata also providing one of the rings, too. So those two senior captains providing the rings. But the coaching staff deserves some brass as well, in this case, gold. And, of course, it starts with the training staff. And Bobby Fisk, listen to the applause for Bobby Fisk. He's the strength coach guy here. And you want to talk about an individual who touches so many of these student athletes in a positive way, helping them to perform at higher levels. This is your guy, Bobby Fisk, strength coach extraordinaire. And, again, it really shows by what an applause he got. All right, it continues with the training staff as well. So important to keeping these athletes healthy, getting them back on the field when we've had injury. Frank Aiello, part of that group, hard work and dedication to the program from the medical side. And so he's going to receive a ring. And you're going to get the coaches too. Augie Freitas getting a ring here. I just missed the director of men's operations, Evan Marquez, who's able to get his ring. So two of the coaching staff members now have received their hardware. Matthew Huey is going to get his next. He is being called up here to receive his ring. And that'll, of course, set up the head coach, Fernando Barboto, who had never made it to the NCAAs despite so much success in his 13 seasons at Iona. But a guy that is a Jersey guy through and through, and he's returned here to NJIT, to Newark, New Jersey, and made such an impact on this program. 32 wins now in his 4 years. Fernando Barboto to get his ring, the head coach of this regular season and conference tournament championship team. And there is Fernando Barboto. Again, believe in greatness. He instilled that into his players this season. And from an individual campaign, or from an individual standpoint, of course, to a team standpoint, greatness was achieved by the 2019 men's soccer program here at NJIT. He was one guy I can tell you firsthand, was excited to get back and maybe not defend the ASUN Championship, because, of course, the team is now going to compete in the America East this season. But he knows a lot of those America East programs. He's very familiar with the programs. He's done so much research and so much film study in anticipation of the 2020 season. So when the season rolls around in the spring, I can tell you that Fernando Barboto will not be complacent. He'll be looking to win another conference championship.
Yeah, all right. Good afternoon, everyone. As we recognize the men's soccer program for winning the ASUNs the previous season, I would like to begin by recognizing those seniors who could not make it today. Captain Victor Puades, Andy Alvarez, Ryan Melnick, and Javier Acton. These last 4 years has truly been a blessing. I want to thank God, my family, and my friends for supporting me through my NJIT career. I want to thank the coaching staff and NJIT for giving me the opportunity to represent the badge and represent the armband. It has truly been an honor. I would also like to thank my teammates, because I've not asked for a better family. My time here is unfortunately done, but the lessons I have learned from this program will last forever. As for the guys who stand behind for another season, carry the torch. And I urge you to not take it for granted and to appreciate every minute of it. It's time to carry the torch, boys. Continue to believe in great. Roll Tech.
Okay, thank you for everybody who came out today, and also thank you to those of you watching online. So last season was so incredible to be a part of, and I'm so glad we finally got these rings to remember that season. So way back in the day, 4 years ago, my first preseason here, I remember Coach took the freshmen aside. I was sitting with Zapata, Nino, Diogo, Zach, Victor, Andy, and a few others, and Coach told us we have 4 years to go to go win a trophy and to go win a ring. And I honestly, at the time, I didn't believe that that could be done. We struggled that season against some of the top ASUN teams, but it's been so amazing to watch our coaching staff transform this program over the years. And so my freshman class over those years went through so much together, and I'm lucky enough to have another year of eligibility, but I'm so thankful that we were able to win this ring with that class before most of them graduated, because honestly, nobody wanted it more than them, and nobody deserved it more than they did. Now this program's in really good hands, and I'm sure that this will not be the last ring. I'm really excited to see what is next for NJIT men's soccer. Thank you.
Thank you, Juan and Rennie. And now please welcome our final speaker, NJIT men's soccer head coach Fernando Barbodo.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for coming out. Really appreciate it. And for all those people watching online, thank you. I'd like to first, I have a long list of thank yous. First, thank President Bloom and Lenny Kaplan for supporting our program. They've been, they've always been there to support, and you know, everything we've asked, they really stepped up. Appreciate it. I'd like to thank all the administrators as well, and a special thanks to Andrew Schwartz, my sports supervisor, the man with the details, and the man who supported me and controlled all my fire. Thanks, Andrew. How are you? I'd like to thank the admissions department. You know, we got here as a coaching staff in March, and we had a couple of months to put a recruiting class together, and that class is the class that will that we're seniors this year. The class that, as Randy mentioned, we sat down and said, you guys got to win us a trophy for at least one trophy in 4 years. And they did better, too. I'd like to thank again the players, all the seniors. They gave everything. They really did. It was an amazing year, special year. And if it wasn't for them grinding it out every day, you know, we wouldn't be standing here. I'd like to give a big hug and a big thank you to my coaching staff, Matt, Augie, Evan, Jr. Those guys were very supportive of the team, of the group, of me, and of all my madness. Again, I'd like to thank my family, too. My three beautiful kids, Maximus, Tristan, Valentina, my little princess. Every time I lost a game, she would text me, Daddy, it's only a game. Anyway, I think one of the biggest things that happened here on this campus was, you know, we came up with coaching staff with a motto called Believe in Great. I got it from, it's a Spanish saying, and in Spanish is creer en grande. And I think that was the greatest thing that happened here during that 2019 season, is that it was the belief. And I think, you know, in the Florida Gulf Coast game, down in Florida, we won 2-1. I think that's when it really started taking off to unbelievable height. And I'm not just talking about the players. I'm not talking just about the staff. It was the administration. I thought the school. Everybody really believed that we could win. And I think that was a really beautiful thing. I remember the championship game. And when I mean everybody believed, here's the great example. It was the last game against Florida Gulf Coast here, championship ASUN game. We win the game. I walk over to my bench to pick something up, and an NJIT police officer comes up to me, hands me a cigar and says, I knew you would do it. So, you know, having everybody believe, having that fever, you know, that vibe on campus, I think was a beautiful thing. And I hope that, you know, in the years to come, it continues and just grows even more so. I hope to see all of you in the spring as we will challenge for more trophies in the America East. And I'm glad that you all came out again. Thank you, and believe in great.
Thank you, Coach Barbado. As we conclude today's ceremony honoring our past accomplishments, please direct your attention to the bleachers as we welcome the 2020 men's soccer newcomers. These individuals will help continue to raise the bar of success for NJIT men's soccer as the future of the program. This past summer, NJIT Athletics transitioned to join the America East Conference. The transition will reward the Highlanders with future growth in both athletic and academic accomplishments. However, as a result of the global pandemic, this fall season was postponed to the spring of 2021. Please stay connected with NJIT Athletics by visiting njithighlanders.com or follow us at NJIT Highlanders on all social media platforms. Thank you for attending today's NJIT Men's Soccer Ring Ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, give a round of applause for your 2019 ASUN Men's Soccer Regular Season and Conference Tournament.
So, America East is now going to be the future for the athletic department here at NJIT after 5 years in a terrific home, the ASUN, which welcomed the Highlanders in with welcoming arms, five terrific seasons. But obviously the desire, the ability to be close in proximity geographically to these teams so that the student athletes can not miss as much time in the classroom and have the shorter trips and the shorter travel. So the America East is on tap when things do get going from an athletic standpoint here for the Highlanders in 2021 as we get into the new year, maybe 2022 if we can get some of the winter sports started earlier. But Albany, Binghamton, University of Hartford, University of Maine, Maryland, Baltimore County, known as UMBC, UMass Lowell, University of New Hampshire, Stony Brook, and Vermont. Those nine teams will now be the rivals, conference rivals here for the Highlanders moving forward. And, of course, the hope is that that will start sooner than later as things get a little bit more clarity from the coronavirus and the ability for testing and the ability to make sure that we ensure the safety of student-athletes moving forward. So that is the future, the America East. It's a conference that the Highlanders have tremendous familiarity with, as all the teams seem to have played so many of these members in non-conference games over the last handful of years, really since NJIT transitioned into the Division I era back in the mid-2000s. And so that will be the new home moving forward. There will be no defense of the ASUN Tournament Championship for the soccer program. I know a lot of the guys wanted to prove to those teams that they could do it again and repeat, but they'll take their talents, they'll take this very good nucleus, this core of players to the America East and try to win back-to-back conference championships in two different Division I NCAA conferences. Boy, wouldn't that be an accolade for an up-and-coming athletic program like NJIT has proven to have here in Newark, New Jersey. So we're continuing to celebrate. The players now have gotten a green light to go and talk amongst themselves and show off those rings to family members who have come out in attendance here to Lubetkin Field at Mal Simon Stadium. And for those who don't know, Bernie Lubetkin was a big donor to this project, to the athletic fields. He and his brothers, in honor of their parents, years ago putting forth money to help this program athletically in honor of, again, their parents. And Mal Simon, of course, J. Malcolm Simon, I mentioned earlier, coached this men's soccer team from 1955 to 1983. So you want to talk about a terrific member of this NJIT athletic community with a soccer field, you know, now named after him, a stadium named after him. So some of the history behind where this program got the names for this facility from. But we're going to move along here. We're trying to recruit some of the members of the team, as well as Fernando Barbado, the head coach of the men's soccer program, to talk a little bit more about today's festivity. I'm curious to pick their reaction to the ring as well, a well-designed ring that I'm sure they'll be proud of really for the rest of their lives to relive the memories of this season in which they tied the program record, single-season record with 10 wins, became the first team here on campus to win an ASUN championship, a tournament championship. They also won the regular season and advanced to the NCAA tournament for the first time for any program here since 1977. This team first went in 74 under Mal Simon men's soccer to the division or the NCAA tournament. They went again in 75 and then again in 77. So they had three in a span of four seasons under Mal Simon for the men's soccer program. And now hopefully some of the other programs will follow suit here for NJIT. And that obviously will happen once the athletic season continues or resumes following COVID. But a look afterwards of all that took place here today. And a lot of thanks went out. You heard Lenny Kaplan and Dr. Joel Bloom speak. Fernando Barbotto, the head coach. Andrew Schwartz was mentioned as well. All right, we are back here, a momentary break, trying to get things lined up, some interviews upcoming for this men's soccer program after the fabulous season it had. And, you know, the wins that they had to record here, we talked about that Stetson game in the semifinals earlier. That was no easy match as well. Stetson gave the Highlanders all they could handle in that 3-2 match before the Highlanders would win against number two-ranked Florida Gulf Coast 2-1. But memories from that game, boy, NJIT falling behind right before the half, 12 seconds in the half, Noah Bushy of Florida Gulf Coast scoring a goal. And I remember going into the half, I was joined as a color analyst behind the melodic sounds of Jason Garrett, who does a play-by-play for NJIT men's soccer. And as much as this team had overcome adversity and continued to shine all throughout the course of the season, did they have another miracle left? Did they have another comeback, another gutsy performance left? 45 minutes to prove they did. And sure enough, in that 70th minute, Thomas Radon setting up the goal by Alejandro Rabel. And then with a 1-1 tie inside of 5 minutes in the match before potentially heading into overtime, Regsan Watkins, the game winner from Andrew Nino. Meanwhile, Samuel Reisges had seven saves in that championship game, and a 2-1 victory was the result. So a season sweep of the Eagles, who the Highlanders had defeated just a few weeks earlier on October 26th down in Fort Myers, a 2-1 win there in that game. As I mentioned during the ring ceremony, Gerald Cubero had both goals in that victory. And the 2-1 win was the final. And they say it's hard to beat a team twice when you play, especially something like soccer, as evenly contested, as hard fought. You know, as they say, the ball can bounce anyway, and that can mean the difference. But two wins over Florida Gulf Coast last year certainly proved that this was the number one team in the class of the ASUN in 2019. And, you know, I talked about being joined by some of the members here, some of the honorees today. We start off in style with the ASUN Player of the Year, a guy that was a national leader, tied for the national lead in goals. My pleasure to welcome in Rennie White. Rennie, you got to first look at this ring. These things are hard to design. It's not an easy thing. What are your thoughts as you proudly display that thing on your ring finger?
Oh, it looks so nice. I mean, a lot of small details went into this. It's just, I couldn't be happier with it.
Such a nice way to remember such a great season. And you can't really beat a dead horse when you talk about accomplishment, personal accomplishment, sacrifice, you know, winning with teammates. As you get this ring, what's the reflection that first comes to mind as you look at? What do you think about when you stare into that baby?
Well, like you said, I did have a lot of personal accomplishments last season, but none of those can compare to seeing this ring. Like, this is what it was all about. And for 4 years, this is all we wanted. And so happy that we won this.
One of the big themes really throughout this whole ring ceremony, I talked about it early on, and then of course it was talked about quite a bit, was believe in great, which is inscribed inside that ring. What did that phrase mean to you, and how did that kind of maybe encapsulate what you experienced with your brothers in 2019?
Well, I'm actually wearing the bracelet right now, believe in great. They a few games into the season, when we were actually not going through a great spell, our coaches gave us these bracelets, and we kind of, I mean, that was the phrase for the rest of the season, believing great, and we started playing better. And so, I don't know, I'm not very superstitious, but soon after we got these bracelets, we started winning. And yeah.
So if my follow-up was you were 2-3-3, if I remember right, and then you wind up going 8-1-1 in your last 10, but 5 wins in a row up until that game in the NCAA tournament. Aside from maybe the bracelet, the good luck bracelet, what clicked? What on the pitch do you think was the difference? What got this team turned around?
We had so much talent last season, and I think that for some of the earlier games in the season, we tried to defend and sit back a little bit and hit teams on the counterattack. But then later on in the season, we kind of figured out that our offense is better than almost anybody we play. So we just started full-out attacking, sending both fullbacks forward, and teams just couldn't defend us. We scored so many goals. We were really dangerous going forward, and I think that's why we had so much success in the second half of the season.
And I know you're a team player and a team guy, so obviously the goals are great, but what did it mean to you to see Regsan Watkins get a chance in that finals game? And remember, he had goals in the two games prior,
yeah.
But to see him get that game winner inside of 5 minutes, what did that look like to you? What do you process? What did you see in that moment?
That was awesome. Regs is one of my best friends, and I think he deserved to be on the field more last season, but unfortunately there was just no room for him sometimes, and I'm so happy for him that he got to score the biggest goal in our program's history.
Yeah, you think about that, right? Like, to make the most of one's moment. Some guys can't step up and deliver. Some guys can. And Rex definitely, when the spotlight was the brightest, was able to come through. So what's next for NJIT? Talk about what you're going through with this whole pandemic, trying to get yourself, you know, ready for another soccer season. What's next for you?
Not exactly sure. It was going to work out really well for me to have my final season this fall because I'm graduating in December. But, now I'm trying to kind of plan out my future. I'm not really sure. I might stay for my master's, and I would be able to play in the spring and fall. So trying to figure that out right now.
Well, there's been so many memories, and obviously what you've done, you had to sit out a year too, so you too are on a sideline watching other guys perform in the spotlight, but it seemed like it was all worth it. And before I let you go, I guess my last question, if we don't get that luxury of seeing Rennie White back on the pitch here in NJIT one last time, what are your memories of this place, and what is maybe your fond way of summarizing what you've been able to accomplish at NJIT?
Well, I'll really never forget this season, and it's all about the ASUN Championship for me. That's something that I'll remember forever.
Well, it's well earned. Wear that ring with pride for a very long time, and every time you look at it, remember those brothers that you had and the accomplishment, because it's a very few and far between. And in an institution like this, where academics is so important, to see athletic accomplishment is very special. And you were a headliner in that group. So congratulations, and enjoy the rest of the day.
Thank you.
Well earned for NJIT. You know, you talk about when you have a soccer team and you have balance, and you have guys who know their roles, and you have a guy who, as Fernando Barbotto said, Rennie White may have been the best finisher he's ever had, a poacher that did things you just can't teach. And so he was able to perform his role and do it well, and it was great to see. And now we have another guy who also was a big part of all that took place, a second-team performer. But when the cards were dealt and the chips were in the middle table, was an all-tournament performer. My pleasure right now to bring in Thomas Radon.
Thank you.
You're smiling most of the day. You've got your ring proudly displayed, popped open right in front of me. I asked Rennie what he thought when he took a look at it. What are your thoughts as you see that puppy?
I mean, more than anything, I mean, of course, it's a beautiful ring, but it's a memory that's going to last forever. A beautiful ring to a beautiful season that we had.
It really was, and I think that what made it even better, too, was the way you won in the championship game, right? Like, this was a team that overcame a little early adversity, a little bit of a slow start.
Right.
You know, you had some games you had to come back in, you fought hard. But now you're 45 minutes away, even closer, to the season ending one win short. But you're able to assist the goal inside the 70th minute, got the game all even back up, a chance then for the game winner. But take us through that last part of the second half of the championship game where you played a big role and your teammates were able to overcome.
I mean, that I actually do remember halftime pretty vividly. I mean, everybody came into the dressing room, and I don't think one person was like, this is where it ends. Everyone was like, okay, 45 minutes, and we got us back. Everyone was talking about the next goal. And every chance we had looked like we were going to score. And fortunately enough, we had that free kick. I actually remember walking up to it. I wasn't even the slightest bit nervous. I just felt like, you know, something's going to happen eventually. And lucky enough, you know, the play went in our favor. And you know, that was the start of the comeback. And once it was the start of our comeback, I actually I knew we were going to win that game, whether it was in overtime or regular time.
And it was, I mean, it was amazing. And you guys could have really gone in the tank mentally because the goal came with 12 seconds to go in the half. I mean, you were so close to having, you know, a tie match going into the break. And so you had to overcome that. But again, I think that's kind of the mentality. And when I talked to Coach about what you've done, he just liked the fact that you're a hard worker. And he said that, you know, Thomas brings a lot of leadership. So that being said, your role in this championship obviously was significant both on and off the pitch. What does that mean to hear a coach speak so fondly of what you've been able to bring to his team, a championship-winning team?
Definitely means a lot because I can speak for myself. I know I'm not the type of person to lead vocally. I try to, you know, even in practice, I try to give guys a hard time. On the field, I always want to be that guy to, you know, back up my teammates and stick in that first tackle, even though sometimes it's not the best idea. But that's who I, you know, I try to be, and I know I could bring that to the team, so it actually means a lot that that's recognized.
And before I let you go, I mean, you're a Jersey guy. Hey, you're a Jersey kid, Sparta, New Jersey. You're here playing at NJIT. The meaning of it, any more significance that you were able to do this kind of in your hometown, your home state, to be close to home and be able to do what you've probably wanted to do from a high school player in New Jersey, now transitioning into a championship college player in the state?
I mean, yeah, of course. It means more, like you said, being from here and then winning domestically with a university so close to home. I mean, I grew up in Garfield, New Jersey, which is 10 minutes away from here. So NJIT, as a kid, I was always playing here. I was always playing on this field against other teams. Not this field per se, but this exact spot. So, you know, it just, memories came back from a childhood, and it's awesome to, you know, bring something back home to this specific area.
How hungry are you to get back out? And again, I wouldn't say defend the title in the sense that the ASUN title defense won't happen, but, you know, a chance to win another conference, two different conferences in 2 years?
Yeah, I mean, it was actually a real big bummer hearing that, you know, the fall season was unfortunately going to be canceled. With a new conference coming up, and it's not panning out the way that we want it to, of course, like, you know, but whatever is thrown at us, we're going to try to win that title. And at the end of the day, that's you know, everybody's in the same situation, right? So we're put in the spring, and we want to win that for sure. I definitely do.
Well, it's good, too, because you've had a longer chance to savor what was accomplished, but now you have more excitement, maybe more anxiety to get back on the pitch and create a new chapter for NJIT men's soccer in a different conference. From what I've seen from the teammates that you have and from how you guys play, could very well happen. Look forward to seeing it again. Enjoy that ring.
I will.
Go enjoy the rest of the celebration with your teammates. And again, great year. We look forward to seeing you play as a senior.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thomas Radon, Jersey guy, obviously a big part of what happened here this season. 16 points this year, 5 goals, 6 assists, and, you know, big goals too, as I talked about. And I think about that assist that he had in the finals to Rebel, which was so important in changing the whole way that game was kind of the outlook of that game felt, you know, getting that thing back even before giving a team a chance to win. And then there's the guy that orchestrated this, and I see he's been really excited about that ring.
Yeah.
Fernando, you and I have talked so much over the years before seasons in terms of anticipation of what you wanted to do and accomplish and how you thought your team looked, and even after seasons like we did when you guys won the championship. Has it been any different now? It's been a while now since that victory, 10 months to the date, but is it still just as vibrant in your mind?
Absolutely. You know, today we're, you know, looking through some of the videos that our sports information put together, and you know, you get real emotional, you know, and you know, I was at Lafayette College as an assistant. We won a championship there the first year, so I reached out to Tim Linehan, who's at Northwestern now, and I said, hey, does it ever go away? Like, I watch videos sometimes and I get all teary-eyed and emotional, and he's like, it ain't ever gonna go away, Fernando. So yeah, it's really very vivid, you know, in my mind at all times.
You think about, I mean, that's why people compete, right? That's why we compete, is to get those moments, to have those moments. And some people don't ever share in that moment. You know, you've got a group of guys that has a chance to get back and do it again. I know this has been tough, but what have you taken now from this fall that normally you'd be playing? What have you taken from this program in the direction they're going, and when we do hopefully get started in the spring with the season in the America East?
Yeah, I mean, listen, I think number one is don't take life for granted, right? Especially not the game, especially not getting back on the field after being out for so many months. So, you know, we step on a field every day, feeling very fortunate. Happy that we're out here training again, and you know, taking little steps, you know, as we move, since we have so much time before we really start up for the spring season. So, yeah, just you know, just enjoying being on the field.
What'd you think of that ring? I see you've got the gold edition. That's box wide open. You don't want to close. I feel like you don't want to close that box. You want that thing wide open.
No, I don't.
Just to keep on looking at it. But talk about the design and the meanings behind you know, what was you know, created for that ring.
Yeah, I think the red was, you know, is what NJIT is, right? Is our main thing, and we wanted the red on there. Me and my coaching staff really, you know, did a great job of trying to capture everything that we could. And place it on this, you know, symbolic ring. And I, you know, one of the things I request is I want regular season championship and playoff championship on there, because both are just as equally important in my mind. And especially the regular season championship, I think sometimes that's overlooked, but it's really the body of work of our coaching staff and of the players and staff. So, it came out great, you know, and, you know, it's just going to be always a constant symbol of what 2019, the best thing of 2019.
Sure thing. I mean, you think about how 2020 has been such a strange year, but that gives you that much longer of a time to just relish in what was accomplished. You know, it's funny, you were talking at the podium, and you did mention to believe in great. I talked with Rennie White, and he said, you know, right after we had started, and he said, I believe it was when we were 2-3-3, which was right before you guys went on a huge run. He said we got these bracelets. He was still wearing it.
Yeah.
You mentioned a little bit where that was from, but what was the inspiration? Tell us the inspiration and maybe the effect of what that means for these young student athletes, not only on the pitch, but off the pitch, believing great.
Yeah. So the, you know, the bracelet, you know, it's funny. I did the bracelet many years ago with another college team, 2009, and we actually won a championship that year. It's crazy how things work out. So, you know, over the summer, I'm like, Matt, let's do this bracelet, you know? And there was a tournament going on, Copa America, from in South America. And I was watching it. Obviously, I'm a soccer coach, studying the game, and a fan. And I saw on the sleeve of you know, of the Uruguayan team, and it said "Creer en Grande," and I'm like, wow, that's really catchy, you know. And so I tried to translate it from Spanish to English, and that's how "Believe in Great" came out. We put it on the bracelets. We talked about it in preseason, and I said, if we don't believe in ourselves, then no one else is, you know. So I think that was something that really resonated. Every day, because we talked about it at the end of every training session. We would see "Believe in Great" and look at each other. So, and it wasn't easy, right? Because as you pointed out, we were 2-3-3. It was not like we were undefeated, but we evolved, and then, you know, and we became, you know, a united group with that goal of being great. So. It's good.
You know, it's funny when you believe in great, there's really no stopping point, right? And it's funny because I listen to you talk, and I think about sports fans who think, well, when a team or a coach wins, they must become a little complacent. But I listen to your players. I listen to you. As much as you guys enjoyed it, I feel like it's fueled even a deeper fire to get back out there and do it again and experience and relive that feeling like you had last year again. Truth to that statement?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a moment when, you know, when you've won, right? When that whistle blew, I think everybody kind of looked around, all the players, even in all the celebration, like, this is such a great feeling. And I think, you know, when you have such a feeling, I think you want to get back there, right? You want to feel that again at its height. And definitely that's a fuel for us, for everyone, right? And that's not just the players, and not just the coaching staff. I think the whole school like wants to see it and feel it, because I'm telling you, those playoff games, like the vibe on this campus was like, it was just so high. It was beautiful. It really was.
Yeah, I mean, even watching those highlights earlier, you know, kind of reliving, you know, the goal to tie it, then the goal to win it, and like the goosebumps and the craziness and the fervor, you know, like everyone pouring onto the pitch after the final whistle sounded. It was great. But like, you know, for you, you and I had talked about it. It was so great because as much success as you've had as a head coach in your past, you got to go to the NCAA tournament. You got to take these kids to an NCAA tournament. So it's great because there's still still some business to get going. And I would imagine that when you sit here and you guys are together, you're thinking to yourselves, okay, we continue to grow this program. We've got the new facility. You know, we've got the ring. We've got a new local conference. Let's keep soaring.
Yeah. No, absolutely. I think, when I first got here 4 years ago, you know, that first class, that senior class, you know, they did great for us, but we said, you guys are going to help us build the foundation of this program as we go along. And every class, you know, adds to it. And certainly, you know, my first recruiting class to leave as seniors and leave champions, you know, it's just going to be a torch that's going to be handed down. And there's going to be expectation. You know, we call it weight of the jersey, right? That jersey that you, every guy from now on puts on is that much heavier because of what was accomplished here.
Yeah. I like that.
Yeah.
And as you're talking too, it made me think, I didn't ask any of the players and I should have, but you know, you and I have talked about it. This was a group of at least the senior class that didn't get to play on this lovely facility.
Yeah.
You talk about earning and putting in your time, you know, blood, sweat and tears, commuting to Kane to play on a field that's not quite this caliber and having to go off campus to do so. I mean, they earned it. I mean, you've got to be so proud, especially of that class, and you'll have more chances with the younger players to do these things again and experience things together. But for that particular class, I mean, explain the feeling of being able to have gotten them through the war and then to the spoils as was.
Yeah, I mean, we talked about it in preseason. We're like, and I emphasized to the newcomers, I'm like, you guys have no idea what this senior class has gone through to be here today, how fortunate, how much, you know, the turmoil they've gone through and adversity, whether playing at Kane or playing training off campus at Bear Stadium in the baseball outfield, just because we didn't have a place while this beautiful, you know, place was being built. It was, you know, I ran out to the field the first preseason training session. And I, you know, I was just jumping for joy. The guys were looking at me like, "What's wrong with him?" And but the senior guys knew, they understood, you know, and they kind of made a joke about it. So every time that I was introduced at a home game, you know, the guys on the bench would be, "No fans, no fans, no fans," because the first thing I ran out to the field, the first training session of preseason, I screamed out, "No more vans!" Like, no more taking vans to off-campus training. So it was, it was really something, you know.
It's great. I mean, it's fine. I know I got to let you go. We sit here, we could talk, we could do this all day. I mean, your story with the police officer, with your daughter's text, everything. Yeah. It all comes together, and it shows why we do what we do, right? This is why you do what you do, and this is why if I'm not as privileged as to be able to coach of the knowledge, even to be a part of talking about it, this is what we do. This is what we want to see, and these kids get this enrichment into the lives, experiences that some kids will never get. Yeah. And a lot of it, of course, was under your hands, so I want to congratulate you and thank you for what you were able to provide those guys, but I know we're going to do it again.
Yeah,
and we're going to have the opportunity sooner than later, and I can't wait to get started with the chance to maybe not defend one crown, but to win another in another conference. So look out, America.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Fernando Barbota will be coming into his fifth year coming up, as mentioned, 8-plus wins in three of them, tying the program record with 10 this year on top of everything else. And so, obviously, he was great. And I apologize to Juan Zapata because I could have talked all day with your coach, because when I get him going, when he's telling soccer stories, I tell you, I can do it all day. But first of all, you had a chance to go up and talk a little bit today, but now you get a chance to sit down, wear the ring. You're smiling big.
Yeah.
What's going through that head of yours?
Man, honestly, it's just a very great moment. Been waiting a very long time for this, honestly, since I got here freshman year. Like Rennie said, you know, we got sat down and we were told, hey, you guys are going to do it. And yeah, I mean, there were times where it didn't always seem like that, you know. We had a couple rough years, a couple rough seasons, and times, you know, guys wanted to give up. But we just kept pushing. It was really great.
One of the last things I asked your coach before he left was, you know, I didn't ask any of the players, but the guys who were seniors in last year's class really earned that ring. I mean, you think about all the vans. We joked around about the vans and having no home, being vagabonds, right, essentially, to coming to a state-of-the-art facility. All the fans that were in attendance during the run through the tournament. What did it mean to you as your final moments here at NJIT as a senior player to have that happen?
It couldn't end in a better way, you know.
Like we said before, we didn't have a home field for the first 3 years. It was like we were just playing against the other team, our parents in the stands. Really, that's really all it was. And then just for it to end the way it did with this field, this facility, all the fans supporting us, it's truly a blessing. True.
Is there a moment, I mean, because you guys started a little bit slowly and then really went on a tear. You had big wins, you had some big games. But when you look at the ring, is there a moment in a game or a specific game or series of games that you think about the moment you look at that championship ring?
I do, let alone with the playoffs, you know, the semifinal, final. I think the game that really made us was a really true test to our character was our VC against VCU in the beginning of the season, because that was a game where it was a dog against dog fight. You know, it was a dog fight that game. It went all the way into OT, and that's after that game I knew we could do it. I really had faith in our group after that game.
And for you as a captain, I mean, that much more satisfying, know that these guys look to you to help get them through some of that adversity and prove that they could play with the big boys?
No, yeah, and of course, and it's the other way around, too. I look at them, and they're honestly what pushed me to do what we did, you know, to, you know, give every second of the game my full energy, all my focus. It's honestly all for my teammates, and I love all of them.
And I think your coach loved you, too. You know, I had long talks with him throughout the course of the year, especially in preparation for some of the broadcasts. And he said, tell me about guys. I want to know what your thoughts are and give me some. And he said, you know, when we started talking about Zapata, he goes, you know, he does the dirty work. He's one of those guys that does the grunt work in the middle. But most importantly, he is our steel, which I thought was an interesting term. I mean, I think steel, I think strength. And this is what he said about you. So let's talk about what that means and from the relationship that you guys had to have to make that happen, the championship, the ring, to be his captain, to be his steel. What does that mean?
It means a lot. I mean, it wasn't always like that coming in as a new guy, as a freshman. I was a very young guy looking up to guys who are in my place now, like MG9, you know, Mamadou, Onyaka, all the Rickies, you know, those guys. I really learned from them, you know, how a leader should be. And then I looked up to them, and then, you know, yeah, I mean, I learned from the people in front of me, and I just hope my guys could carry it on, you know. They see my example, and they continue to carry the torch.
And I'll ask you a final question. Same thing I asked Thomas Radon. He's a Jersey guy. You're a Jersey guy. Does it make it that much cooler to be, like, in your home state, like, on your turf, and being an ASUN championship champion on your turf?
No, yeah, it's a very beautiful thing, you know, to go around. I'm across the river. I'm a Kearney guy. 10 minutes away, so it's honestly a very, because I know a lot of guys that used to go to NJIT too from Kearney, and they didn't do what we did, you know, they weren't able to. So I'm truly blessed to be able to have done it.
Yeah, and I'm sure too that you're proud too, because you've seen this place grow tremendously. I mean, this wasn't what NJIT soccer was when you were being recruited.
No, yeah, it really wasn't. I remember the old field because my old high school used to play here too, so really crazy how things, you know, end up at the end.
Yeah, and on the same location geographically, different field, much different facility, you were able to win an ASUN championship in your final home game as a Highlander. Dude, it's been fun watching you play. It's going to be disappointing that when we come to see NJIT soccer, we're not going to be able to watch you out there again.
It's okay.
But the memories we got, the last memories, will be the best.
Yes,
congratulations,
for sure.
And enjoy that ring and enjoy the memories of this year.
Thank you. Can I
shake your hand? Yeah. All right, Brian. All right, that, of course, winds up on one of the captains of this team, and he mentioned growing up 10 minutes away across the river. Pretty awesome. And so we have what, photos coming up for you? Is that correct? Some photos. Okay, some photos of the championship run. Let's get a look at these. Can I get up and go see his monitor? Will his monitor have him? Oh, crap. That we we do so very well at NJIT, and I really applaud the athletic department, is they know how to promote their own. And then you think about the walls that are in the facility, the WEC, the Wellness and Events Center, with the men's soccer program and the trophy case and the men's basketball wall with the win over Michigan, et cetera, et cetera. They do a great job of really being proud of what they accomplished and who they are, student athletes who excel both in the classroom and in the field of competition. And then you get moments like this. They don't grow on trees, but you get moments like this where everything comes together, and the source of pride as an organization, as an athletic department, as an institution, on display. 2019 ASUN Champions regular season and tournament. There wasn't a moment better. Thanks for sharing in our celebration on the Highlander Sports Network.